So what is the solution for people who are working from home when it comes to discipline, when it comes to things like exercise, when it comes to mental health, for having a structure or a routine around the way they work? Is there any advice you can give, worldly advice?
Surely. Why not? You see, look, I'm telling you my situation. I love my granddaughter. I can't live without her. Now I can't even see her because in case I catch, you know, infection from her. So I'm really struggling. So tremendous discipline is required for me to keep away from her, because it's not being, oh, kind of emotional and, oh, I love my, I must grab her and, you know, hug her, asking for trouble. So we have to be very pragmatic and practical. So we, you see, this is not a short-term thing. This is the worrying part. This particular virus is not going to go away in a month or whatever. So we suspect it may go on for a year before we get a vaccination. So we have to now readjust our routine lifestyle to take into account this new situation that we face. So how do we do that? Look, we have to isolate ourselves. We are stuck. In a way, it is forcing us to try and live, you know, within ourselves rather than live externally. The world had gone completely wild in a highly materialistic mode, and mixing with people, socializing, drinking, pubbing, clubbing, and, you know, going on cruises. All this has been stopped instantaneously, just chopped off. This highly frenzied materialistic lifestyle has been severely challenged. So it's gone. It's really struggling. So we now have to refocus our attention of living a much more, if you like, a much more a spiritually oriented life rather than a materially oriented life. So if somebody says, is there a silver lining to this horrendous virus we have? The silver lining is this. We have been, in a way, given a real jolt, a real smack, saying this very highly materialistic vision with which you have been living, live up to the hype. That has been now severely challenged and put on the back burner, saying you can't live that anymore. So now we have to readdress our issue and say, how do we lead our lives? What do we do? We don't know what to do because we are not used to living in isolation. And now we are forced to live in isolation. So what is the positive side? Look, whenever you get any challenges, come fighting, says Swami Vivekananda, and then you turn it into an opportunity. So the opportunity is this. It is possible for us to now say, look, I can't mix with so many people anymore. I'm fed up of watching TV or doing YouTube or what. So what do? I focus inward. So rather than focusing on outward life, I focus on the inward life. So say, I never bothered to explore my own inner being. What is the state of my mind, etc. Now I've got the, I don't have an opportunity. I've been forced to look inward. So this is the time where you can say, okay, I thought about sitting for meditation every day for half an hour, whatever. I didn't have the time. Now I have got all the time I like. So I can sit for meditation. I will struggle. But at least I've got the opportunity to try and explore the deeper aspect to myself, my inner being. So this is the opportunity for us to look inward. And you see, this is boring. It's not boring. The inward journey, in fact, is perhaps the most exciting journey a human being can take on. This is what Hinduism is all about. So in a way, it has pressurized or forced us to, in a way, spend more time with ourselves, what is our true nature, and realize what a mess we are in, and try and correct this mess.